Addressing a high-level stakeholders dialogue organized by the Uganda Women Parliamentary Association, UWOPA, the Minister of State for Youth and Children Affairs, Sarah Mateke, invited legislators to work hard on a strong family institution and emphasized the need for co-parenting.
We may empower the women, we may provide all these services, but I pray that we really strengthen the issue of the family institutions. If we do not strengthen the family institution, whatever you're taking to the local people, even if it is PDM, you stop people killing each other. Even if it is YLP, you look at web, whatever program we are taking there, before we strengthen the family institution, before we value these families and we put parenting as key issues in whatever messages that we are bringing, then we are wasting a lot of time.
Mateke also reminded women that female gender empowerment does not mean suppressing men, saying the practice has resulted into family breakdown.
Much as we are looking at the women, I think empowerment doesn't mean that we should now be suppressing the men. I delayed to come because I met a young man from Turkey, and he had married a girl from here, and the girl has disappeared with the child. Now we are empowering, now you're disappearing with somebody's child. There is a problem.
On March 8th, Uganda will join the rest of the world to commemorate the International Women's Day, which will be celebrated under the theme Counter in Accelerating Gender Equality Through Economic Empowerment. The minister has highlighted challenges which are still affecting the women despite several government interventions.
We have different challenges that continue to prevail. The issue of gender-based violence is still a challenge, and it is still within us. The issue of ownership of property among the women is still very key. The school dropout rate among the girls is still high.
Sarah Openly, the chairperson of Uganda Parliamentary Association, also emphasized the need for the government to step up efforts to curb domestic violence and tipped women to desist from keeping money at home, saying the practice has fueled violence between marriage partners.
When we went to Abim, we found this poor lady whose husband had pierced her eye with a spear. And to our surprise and shock, the reason for this violence was because the woman asked the man to also engage in some economic activity, because she was the one actually working.
Adriana Franco Chitanana, the country representative of the Lutheran World Federation, emphasized a need to reflect on the achievements made by women and identify existing gaps for solutions.
While progress has been made, challenges persist. And for refugee women, there are additional barriers to economic empowerment, including limited access to formal employment, lack of access to land, limitations affecting freedom of movement, lack of collateral for loans, and limited market opportunities.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.